And cold weather and cold water can make for some tough fishing conditions. But now the sun is up, we've had a couple warming days. This is when the action couldn't get good. We're gonna go check it out. Hey, welcome to the show.
We're now south of 55. We're gonna take a little scenic drive. Down Interstate 49. We're just looking for a good time. Better buy another case of beer. Cause you know you're gonna need it here. Time to go. Yeah, we're gonna start the show. It's time to call your friends and let the fun begin. Party's on.
Oh yeah, baby. You can swing him in. Yeah. There you go. That's what I'm talking about. Ooh, put the spot lock on here. There you go. Yeah, he ate that one. They're just starting to move up. This water temperature is about 51. It's starting to finally warm up, and they're starting to react. They're getting fat, they're ready for pre-spawn, and they're eating that bladed jig. That's when it gets fun.
Oh man. You're right, spinnerbait, Jimmy. Good call.
I'll tell you what, dude, and you even said it before, you can't be making your own. Oh. Well done. There you go, man.
Take a look at that. You landed that spinnerbait.
There you go.
Nice.
Come here. Come here. Oh, that's a good one there. Yeah, that's what I want. You know what? You can't... I'll show you something here. It's always nice catching fish. There's no doubt about that. But what's really nice is when you catch them on baits that you made. That's not offered in a store. That the only way you can do that is by putting it together, and it's so nice. I mean, we got 51 degree water. Look at that beautiful fish right there. And that's exactly what you want. But making your own baits is so cool because you're the one who makes a decision. And it was cool. I built that for this reason, for cold water like this, and it played out fine.
Another bladed jig fish, Jimmy.
Even this cold water, we're starting to figure it out.
Yeah, a little different color I was using, but...
Starting to figure it out.
Yeah, going over, buddy.
Nice.
Another bladed jig.
Thought it was a bass. I think I got a striper here, though. Oh, man, that's fun. Those are always fun. If I can get them in here. They always hit so hard. Oh, that's fun. And watching him come up and eat it was a cool thing. Yeah, there he is. Look at that. Isn't that pretty? Look at that. That is so pretty. What a cool fish to catch on a bladed jig. Oh, man. I love it. I love it. One of my favorite fish to catch, too, is a hybrid. They're so cool. And they're so strong. Yeah. Come here, buddy. Well... You're going to be, I know you're not happy about it. I know that for a fact, but I got you. But I got you. Yeah. Oh, man, did he eat that thing. Goodness gracious, look at that. Isn't that a pretty fish? That is so cool. What a nice extra bonus today. We're having a lot of fun catching bass in this cool water, but I watched that striper come in and eat it. You talk about cool. Man, there's nothing better than that. Look at that beautiful fish right there. I love it. Hey, we'll be back right after this.
This segment of Jim Crowley Outdoors is brought to you by these and other fine sponsors.
Oh, I got a fish. A good one, too.
There's another good one there. Come here. Yeah. Nice. Yeah, they're really starting to... It's all about water temperature, and that's finally what we're starting to find. You can see this fish has been up here for a while. It's black. Put her back right there. Okay, so here's what we got going on. Now we finally got into an area where the water temperature has got 52, 53 degrees. This time of year, it makes such a huge difference. I mean 1 or 2 degrees. We were catching fish in about 50, 51, but it took till later in the day, and today it is later in the day.
Now the water temperature's starting to rise a little bit. One of the things that's going to heat up first, besides rock, is going to be wood. And we've come into a little area back here that's got a lot more wood on it. So now I'm just taking that bladed jig, and all I'm doing is throwing it around those laydowns and moving it slow. We're going to go over the equipment a little bit later and tell you exactly what we're doing. Now we finally got into an area, like I said, with that water temperature rising. Now we're going to get to work. Another striper? Are you kidding me? Putting spot lock on here, man. This is crazy. I've never had it like this where stripers and largemouth get back in an area. You know they're chasing bait. The water's warming. This is so cool. This is so cool. And all on a bladed jig I made. I love it. I love it. I love it. Come here. Come here. At all. Like that. Yeah, they're eating it good. How cool those fish are. They're so awesome. They're so awesome. Check this out. We're just about at the end of the run right here. There's another decent one right there. I threw that up in about 6 inches of water and they're eating it. You know what? Largemouth can never get too shallow, even in cold water when that sun starts warming it. Fun. Oh, it's a good one. Look at that one. Oh, my goodness. Oh, yeah. Yeah, buddy. I said it before, but there's nothing better than catching fish on baits you made. It's really, really cool. Oh, you know what? Hey, let's go back to the studio. I'm going to show you how to build this one so you can have some success with it.
A bladed jig is one of my most effective lures. Matter of fact, I have one on from the first cast of the year up on the deck to the last cast of the year. I have a lot of confidence in that bait, and I have more confidence in it because I build my own. Now, all the lures that I build, whether it be swim jigs, whether it be my regular heavy cover jigs, spinner baits, and bladed jigs, I get all those components from Lure Parts Online. Now, one thing about bladed jigs is when you go to Lure Parts Online, there are more combinations there for you to make exactly what you want than any other place out there. There's more colors of blades. There's more colors of heads. There's definitely more skirt colors. There's literally thousands of combinations that you can make and you decide on. You can build them with your family. I know over the winter, I talked to a bunch of people who they were building them with their sons or building them with their daughters, and then they take them out during the year and see who can catch the fish on them. Nice thing for us is whether you're just a weekend angler or a competitive angler is that everybody wants a competitive edge, right? You always want to feel like you have something more than somebody else. And building your own lures, that can give you that competitive edge. I know one thing for sure, it will definitely give you more confidence. When I can match my blades with my skirt colors about what I feel the fish is going to want, that gives me a lot more confidence. Now, just so you know, there's only 5 components that make up a bladed jig. It's pretty simple. You have the blade, you have the head, you have the skirt, and then you have the split ring, and you have the swivel. Now, the important thing to know when making a bladed jig is you can now, since you're building it, you can make the action how you want it. Your standard bladed jig, or vibrating jig, or chatterbait, whatever you refer to it as, has a straight inline action. To make it do that, you need a size 4 split ring when you're building your own. That will keep the bait more in line. As the water temperature warms, for me, after it gets over that 60 degree mark, I like the bait to hunt a little bit more. That's when I'm going to build the bait with a size 3 split ring. It will cause the bait to move from side to side. It will hunt more. Now, a couple other things you should know. The length and the type of your trailer will change the action on the bait as well. In colder water, I want a more inline trailer. In other words, one that doesn't have that much action. That's like the one that I'm using today. When the water temperature warms, again, like I said, over that 60 degree mark, then I'm probably going to use a paddle tail type trailer. That's going to give that bait more action. So you can choose what you want to build it exactly the way you want. That will give you a competitive edge. Now, let's build it.
years of tug of war took that toll on me. Yeah, well, I was really gonna give it up, gonna pack my bags and leave. Yeah, Granddad sat me down, said, boy, you got this wrong. And his words of wisdom filled the room. You know, they turned into this song. Do you wanna be happy? Be happy, 'cause you're never right. So you're never right.
As you can see, building bladed jig doesn't take very long. And here's something else that you should know, that you can build three of your own bladed jigs for the price of one store-bought one. It's really cost-effective, and I'm convinced it's more effective. You can do whatever you want. Hey, in the wintertime, to build some of these bags, you can get together with some of your fishing buddies, or not, or even have a contest with your family and build and see who has the most effective one. Building lures is not just something you can do yourself, but it's something that can bring the family together and give another part of the sport to enjoy. Like I said, it's cost effective, it's fun, and it's always fun catching fish. It's really cool when you get to catch them on stuff that you made. You want to find out more, you want to find out more about this, you can go to lureparts.online.com and order anything, pick anything that you want. But I'm going to show you right now, I'm going to go through all the components, and I'm going to give you the item numbers on these components. So if you want to build this Table Rock Shad, this is 3/8 ounce, and the blade color, everything. So I'm going to put all the components up here. So you're going to see the blade, then you're going to see the split ring size, which is 4, then you're going to see the snap lock, you're also going to see the skirt color and the head color. So you can match this identically. It'll also give you a way that you can see how easy it is to put all this stuff together and mix and match, and you can go and build your own. Like I said, go to lureparts.online.com, have some fun, build your own baits. Let's get back to the show. We got more bass to catch.
This segment of Jim Crowley Outdoors is brought to you by these and other fine sponsors.
This is just crazy, man. There are stripers back here with these largemouths. Look at this.
Another one.
Yeah. You know you got the right color bladed jig when you got both largemouth and smallmouth, or stripers, hybrids hitting them. Man, is that cool. And he ate that tail again. Those are such a cool fish. That's when you know there's a lot of bait fish back here. When you start getting largemouth and stripers back here feeding them, you know there's bait fish back here. That's cool. Yeah. We found them now, baby. We found them now. Woo! You swiped at it and you missed it. Little guy, but they're here.
Run over, buddy.
Nice.
An unbladed jig.
Nice going. They are just really reacting to that bait now, dude.
They are.
Nice one.
Nice one, buddy. Another one.
Yeah.
It's just so amazing how water temperature 2 to 3 degrees, isn't it?
It is. It makes a huge difference. And you know, we started out today in stocking caps and right now.
Yeah. Nice.
A little bit nicer day. He took that all the way down.
As always, I wanted to go over the equipment that we use today, and I've been working on a bladed jig rod that suits me for the last couple years, and this is what I've settled on. For the rod, we're going to start with that, and that's an American Tackle Bushido Blank, and I built this rod with the American Tackle Microwave Guide System, as well as a handcrafted carbon reel seat. Handcrafted carbon is extremely sensitive and very light, so I can feel every movement of that blade. And on a bladed jig, that's very important, because when you feel an interruption or you feel that vibration stop, chances are that's when that bass has that blade and you need to set that hook. This is a very parabolic action. This is an MB73 8-15. And if you like throwing bladed jigs like I do, or even throwing spinner baits as well as lipless baits, this is a great blank for that. It will do all those things. So like I said, this is a 7-3. It's got a great fast tip, so when that fish comes up and sucks that bait in, that rod can just load. And on a bladed jig, a rod tip that loads is essential for great hook sets. Now the reel I have on here is important too, and this is a Bassinator from Cast King, and this has a 6:6:1 gear ratio. I don't like a real fast gear ratio for bladed jigs. That way I can just keep a nice easy retrieve on that, and this reel does it great. It's good for a lot of other things too. It has 10+1 ball bearings, and what the plus one on Cast King always means is that there's always one ball bearing that's designated to the instant and reverse. That's how come these reels have such a rock solid anti-reverse. So it's 10+1 ball bearings on this reel, 6:6:1 gear ratio, and the reel weighs only 6.4 ounces. It's really light, it contours to your hand really easy, and it's a great all-around reel, but as you can obviously tell, I really love it for a bladed jig. Now the line I'm using is a line I've been using for the last 3 or 4 years with bladed jigs, and that's Suffolk's Advanced Fluorocarbon, and that's in 17-pound test. I've tried lighter, I've tried a little bit heavier, and 17-pound has always worked great for me, and it doesn't matter what I'm doing. I can be throwing a bladed jig, I can be pitching and flipping a heavy cover jig or a plastic worm. This is a very easy, castable line, and it's also very abrasion resistant and very, very strong. This is my complete setup for bladed jig. I think I finally found one that I'm really happy with.
I don't know what I got here, but this one's strong. Oh yeah. Yeah, that's staying down. That's probably another big striper. Whoa, buddy. No, it's a big largemouth. Oh my goodness. That's a big largemouth. Take my time on this one. There you go. Come on, baby. We're just gonna take our time with you. Take our time. Yeah. Just let her do whatever she wants to do. Whatever she wants to do. Come here. Come on in. Come here. Come on.
Yeah, buddy! Oh! Man, now that is a fish, and that is a way to end an awesome day. Oh my goodness. Ooh. What a great, coming out early, froze our butt off this morning, and still had a great time. Oh my goodness, oh my goodness. Hey, we're gonna take one quick break, and then we're gonna close up, because this one, I gotta get a picture of this one. Yeah, it's time to let that big girl go. Man, is that fun. Look at that. Isn't that beautiful? What an awesome, awesome fish. All right. Hammer, hammer. There you go. Go ahead. See ya. Hey, before we leave today, we got to say, we stayed at the Giant Goose Ranch. Anybody can do that. Anybody can come here. We're going to put the information out here because we stayed in some awesome cabins. Met some really nice people who are here, but anybody can come and fish this place. And if you have the opportunity, I would come and rent a cabin here. It's a pretty incredible place. Hey, God bless us with an awesome day today and another awesome adventure. And I hope he does exactly the same for you on your next fishing trip. Until next time, I'm Jim Crowley. God bless you. We'll see you soon.